project. They work to rebuild a sustainable oyster population in New York harbors. Pete and Tanasia are our clients. They've asked us to bake cupcakes for this event that they are throwing. We need to make 2 dozen oysters, 2 dozen mussels, and 2 dozen shrimp cocktail cupcakes for the event. And then, very cool, we got a call from Delmonico's, one of New York's most iconic steakhouses. And no surprise, they want us to make steak cupcakes for a very special birthday party. For the dinner party at Delmonico's, we need to make 15 steak cupcakes and 90 asparagus total. And then last but not least, we are heading to the Staten Island Children's Museum. We're going to work with Aaron, who's an entomologist, which means that he wants the gloves. We've been asked to make 12 cockroach cupcakes and 12 tarantula cupcakes. We're going to surprise some of the children that he's putting on a show for with some bug cupcakes.
I really wish you would make something that I eat a lot, so I have a better visual.
This isn't about you.
That's the biggest problem right there.
So we have this one mold, so it's important that it stay intact for all these oysters. We're going to take these melted down white chocolate and do a few stripes in here. And then we're going to take some white and also paint over it. The next step is to pop it in the freezer. Let's talk about the Billion Oyster Project. Pete and Tanasia are our clients. They've asked us to bake cupcakes for this event that they are throwing.
We are having some of our staff members and community partners come out for a nice event today.
So while the mold hardens up, we need to make the best part, which is the oyster meat that goes in here. So Mom, this is for you.
I'm taking chocolate cake and a little salted caramel frosting to give the oyster meat that actual sea salty taste of the ocean.
Go for it.
Wow.
Okay.
See what happens.
Here it goes.
So you have to go super gentle around the edge. When we took that first shell out of the freezer, it just wouldn't come out of the mold.
It's already cracking.
It started cracking and everything started to fall apart, and we realized that we needed to change something.
Do you think it's because it's not thick enough?
So we thought of adding a little bit more chocolate, even though it may be a little thicker than a real oyster.
You know, since the other one broke, I'm going to just put a thicker layer of chocolate in hopes that this one doesn't crack when we go to take it out.
We are going to take the oyster meat and cover it in fondant.
And wrap it up.
Keep working on that. Let's grab that shell out of the freezer. I always get nervous when things don't work, but I'm really hoping that second time is perfect and we can really make this work because I don't want to start from scratch with this shell.
Let's try this one now.
All right, this thicker chocolate.
I think you got it. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
All right, amazing. The extra melted chocolate worked. Crisis is averted. We can keep going on these oyster cupcakes. So we're going to stick that in, and then, you know, in an oyster, like, there's, like, a layer of, like, it's usually seawater.
Yeah.
So we're going to take a little bit of corn syrup and go around. Okay, so this is our oyster, and we need to make a billion of them for the Billion Oyster Project, but we also have to make shrimp cocktail and mussels and some ice. So we have so much left to do.
The process for making mussels is actually the same as we did for the oysters. We're doing muscles. I'm using the mold as a shell for the